I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Dang, bro, like...
This fight, you and Julio, you can make it happen. You want the fight. He wants the fight. He tweeted out the video when I said, come fight Gabe Rosado. Yeah. Your videos, when you post them on your social media, have 200,000 views, more than a lot of other fights out there.
Yeah, bro.
So hopefully it happens.
Yeah, it's a fight that should definitely happen, bro. And it's like, you know what I mean? We got to do it, man, for the fans. And this, look, is, I mean, Angulo, though. I mean, I'm coming off a win, so let's get it popping, bro.
Now, tonight, Victor Ortiz was at your house. I didn't know you guys were friends.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Me and Vic, man, been friends for a minute, bro.
He said he's known you for a long time.
Yeah, since I moved to L.A. You know what I'm saying? Me and him hit it off. He's cool peoples, man.
Is there anybody in boxing who doesn't like you?
No, man, I'm pretty much cool with everybody, man.
Even people you have beef with, that doesn't last. It's like, you remember you and Jay Leon had a little bit, but then squashed it.
No,
he's
all
good. I know.
It's all good. It's all love when I see Jay.
But the few people that you're still waiting for.
I actually saw Triple G on the plane. We was both on the same plane going to Mexico City.
No way.
So I'm walking on the plane. I see Tom. I say, hey, what's up, Tom? And somebody taps me, and I look to the side, and it's Triple G.
That's cool. What did he tell you?
No, we
How
just,
long ago was this?
We shook hands. It was a couple days
last week,
ago.
Right?
Last week.
He went to the side. What did you do in Mexico?
I was in Mexico with some friends out there, he was out there doing some boxing event.
He went to the hospital, and he went with you. People say to this day that you gave him the best fight.
Yeah, it was a good fight, man. But no, I think Canelo gave him a good fight. I'm saying it's definitely a fight that I would like once again. You know what I mean? And look, it's just a matter of just me proving myself. You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody knows what they get when they see me, but my last performance, everybody's like, wow, I'm impressed. I thought Gabe was done. He looked really good. You know what I'm saying? And it's just about staying consistent and putting on another performance like that. I mean, once I stay consistent, man, they're going...
Okay, let me ask you this.
It's whoever now.
Canelo, Triple G, the first fight. How did you score it, and what happens in the rematch?
I had a slight lead for Triple G, but I don't think it was a fight that was so one-sided. You know what I'm saying? It was a pretty even fight. I'm saying in the rematch, I'm saying I think I give the edge towards Canelo. I'm saying, but it's a good fight if it happens. I'm saying,
like, hopefully you get the winner.
Hey, man, definitely, bro. Look, you got Billy Joe and Lemieux.
Oh, you're right.
You got Danny Jacobs, who, look, I want Danny Jacobs. That's another fight I want. You know what I'm saying? Like, I told Golden Boy, I said, look, man, y'all can make that fight with Danny Jacobs.
He just won.
He beat Arias. I just won my last fight. I mean, I don't know when he looks to fight again, but, you know, we can fight. You know, he got Eddie Hearns as promoter. And, I mean, I fought for Eddie Hearns when I went to Liverpool to fight Martin Murray. Thought I beat Martin Murray like a lot of people thought. So, you know what I mean? That's a fight we can make. You know what I'm saying?
What do you tell Dan if he's watching?
I think Danny Jacobs is talented, you know what I'm saying? But I think at this point in our career, you know, I think we're both around the same age. I think my boxing IQ, I beat him, you know what I'm saying? I still see him doing things as green, you know what I mean? And I think I can outsmart him, you know what I'm saying? And it's just, like I said, man, it's just a matter of being consistent. I looked good in my last fight, and the reason I looked good is because I was healthy. Not only was I healthy, but I was focused. I went back to Philadelphia, went back with my old trainer. I changed a
He's
lot
a
of...
He's a great trainer.
Great trainer. I changed a lot of
Shout
things.
Shout out to Billy.
Shout out to Billy Briscoe. I changed a lot of things, bro, because this game is so mental, bro. You can... I don't care how many miles you put in. I don't care how many rounds you spar. It's mental, bro. If your mind ain't right, if you're not focused, if you're distracted, it's going to throw you off, and it's going to show the day of the fight. So my last fight, man, I made sure that I was mentally prepared, focusing prepared, because I knew that Glenn Tapia can't beat me. I knew the only way I lose that fight is I beat myself.
Let me ask you this. Dana White, I was there. He said he's getting into boxing. You fought in BKB. You were a champion in BKB, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, yeah.
You actually fought Curtis Stevens in BKB, correct?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That was a good fight. Ended in a draw, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, yeah.
But you won before you fought the guy from Texas.
Yeah.
Who fought Chavez. And
I knocked out Brian Vera.
Yes, you did. Yeah. Is there anyone in the UFC that you would like to box?
UFC?
Do you follow it close enough to know him? Or? I mean, Conor fought 170 against Nate Diaz.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, look, everybody says that, you know, they'll fight Conor in the ring. I'm the only fighter that says I'll fight Conor in the cage.
Do you have experience wrestling and doing all that?
No, I got experience doing all that, but...
The boxing will be enough for you.
I'm not going to go into that fight ignorant and say, oh, I could just beat him on my feet. I mean, obviously, you know, I'm going to
learn some defense.
I'm going to have to pick up a coach, you know, somebody that's going to show me some defense on the ground, whatever, if it ever gets down to that. But I will fight him in the cage.
You're from Philly.
I'll fight him in the
cage. North Philly?
Like, and it's not it's not me just saying it. Like, I really would.
You mean it.
I would enjoy that. I think I would enjoy that experience, bro. It's different. Like, BKB, it was different. It was the pit. No ropes. And when I remember when I first heard about it, I was like, what?
Let me tell people, those who don't know BKB, it was a circle.
Yeah, it was a circle.
And the most you could take was 2.5 steps back.
Yeah, because it was 17. It was 17 by 17.
That's it.
Small circle, no ropes.
And nowhere to go.
And it was just toe-to-toe.
Fighting in the pocket.
It was fighting in the pocket, fighting in the phone booth. So what made me want to do it was just like, wow, this is different. You know, I want to do this, and I enjoyed it.
You did. You became a big star. You made good money with that. I mean, they loved you. They promoted you.
No doubt. So look, man, you know, I'd be the first boxer to say I'll fight Conor in the ring, in the cage.
Let's see if it happens. There you have it. Stay tuned, everyone. This is Debbie. Be careful. She's very trained. Not a fan of the camera. She's shy. Stay tuned. Gabe, tell me where to follow you on Twitter, Instagram.
Hey, man. King Gabe Rosado. That's Twitter, Instagram. Follow me, man.
There you have it. Stay tuned. EsNews.com. I'm Elie Seckbach. Reporting. Reporting.
Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rocking with the best. Elie Seckbach. The wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. EsNews. He came a long way. All the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind. Competition. He abusing them.